They say that those who don't believe in magic will never find it. So believe, despite all your doubts, that I will create caramel cream puffs. So, instead of making our usual pastry cream, I'm gonna do a tuna salad filling. So we're gonna start with some flaked tuna, and you can even use the hot and spicy one if you like. Okay, a little bit more. And then I'm gonna add in some celery for some crunch, not too much. And then a little bit of carrot as well. Nice color and sweetness. And then some pickle relish for that nice zestiness and sweetness. I'm gonna add in some mayonnaise. I'm gonna mix this up. I wanna make sure first that I have enough mayonnaise before I season it. Okay, so the tuna is flavorful enough, so I'm not gonna add any more salt, but I will add some pepper. Okay, let's just mix this up, and our filling is ready. You can set this aside, and now we can work on the cream puffs. So making cream puffs is such a foreboding task, but actually, you can do it at home. So the first thing you need is to boil some water with some butter. So I have here 250 ml of water, and I'm gonna add in 80 grams of unsalted butter. So just let that boil and melt together. Okay, so our water and butter are boiling. And once it's boiling really hard, you can add in your flour. This is about 120 grams of flour. You're gonna put everything in at the same time. And once the flour is in, just mix. Just make sure you don't get any of the dough on you. And you wanna keep mixing, but this time over low heat. So if you find that it's boiling too fast, you can take it away from the flame. And you just keep mixing until you cook the dough and it starts to come away from the pot, so it ceases to become sticky. And that's what we're approaching right about now. Okay, so once you've cooked the dough enough and mixed it hard enough, what's gonna happen is it's gonna be not sticky, so you can put your finger in and it's gonna come away clean. So we're gonna let this cool off for just a little bit. And the next thing we're gonna do is add in some eggs. So at this point, if you want to take the easy way out, as I say, you can use a food processor, just put this in, and just buzz it with your eggs. If not, you can do it by hand as well. And again, away from the heat, you don't wanna scramble the eggs. So one whole egg in, and mix. So be careful, you don't want the eggs splashing all around you, but you wanna make sure that the egg is incorporated into your dough. And what's gonna happen is once you add in the egg and you mix it enough, it's gonna get sticky again. I know that sounds really strange, like you made it not sticky and then you made it sticky again, but believe me, this is the process to do it. Okay, so once all of the eggs have been incorporated in, so what you're gonna be left with is a dough that looks like overwhipped mashed potatoes, something like that. So using a rubber spatula, because it's really sticky, you're gonna put it inside of a pastry bag. Now if you don't have a pastry bag, you can probably wing it with a couple of spoons and just spoon it in, but it's really best to use a pastry bag. So what you wanna do is hold the pastry bag by the tip and cover your hand with the rest of the plastic. And you get a little bit of the dough, just put it straight inside. So once you have the dough in the pastry bag, just grab a baking sheet with a parchment paper or wax paper. And you can use a little bit of the dough to actually stick your paper on it. Just put a little bit of the dough here at the corner, and then your paper is gonna stick to it. So that's one of those few tricks that they taught us in school. So now we're gonna pipe in our cream puffs. Just put your pastry bag straight up like that. Press till you get a nice round shape, and then just pull up. Okay, we'll do another one. Just straight up, press. So I'm just gonna keep making these cream puffs, and then I'm gonna put them in the oven at about 200 degrees Celsius for about 30 to 45 minutes or until they're golden brown and a little bit dry in the middle. Okay, one more step before I put these in the oven. Just a little bit of egg wash on top to get a really nice golden brown color. So I'm gonna need one more egg. I seem to have run out of eggs. Wait. Okay, I want you to take a look at this. Nothing inside, but then, look at that. There's an egg. Okay, so it's been about 35 minutes, and I think we've got a really good color on our cream puff, so let's take a look. Oh, these look really good. Take a look at those babies. Nice and golden, and then they're very, very light inside. That means it's fully cooked and ready to be stuffed. Okay, so these look like cream puffs, but there's one more step to make them look really authentic, and that's a caramel. Now, I'm not just gonna make any kind of caramel, I'm gonna make a fish sauce caramel. So first, some sugar. This is ordinary white sugar. I'm gonna put about 100 grams into my pan, maybe a bit more, there you go. And then, I'm gonna add in some patis or fish sauce. And then just a little bit of water to get it going. Just want enough water to make sure that your sugar is wet. That way it's easier to make a caramel without really burning your pan. Okay, let's set this to high heat. And once it gets that really nice brown caramel color, you just pour it on top and we're done. Hey, these look gorgeous. I want to taste one right now. I've got a nice one here. Let's take a bite. That's very nice. The dough is very eggy, and then inside you've got that smooth tuna salad, and then on the outside you've got that salty sweet caramel. This is really, really good. Take my word for it. You gotta try this at home. And if you take a look at my cream puffs, they look like cream puffs, but they're not really cream puffs. But the taste, that is not an illusion. It is really good.